In this video, I want to talk about selection in Blender 2.8. So I'm in the process of learning Blender myself. I'm coming from a Modo Maya background, so it's been a lot of fun just translating, you know, the current workflows I have in other modeling applications and seeing how it works here in Blender. So I am by no means a Blender expert. I just wanted to make a video to post it out there to see if this helps anyone else who's coming to Blender from other applications. So to get started, I'm going to just create a mesh. So what I'm gonna do is hit the Shift A, and that's gonna open up this menu that's gonna allow me to choose a mesh. I'm gonna work here with this UV sphere. And you'll notice that it creates the UV sphere, and it creates it right here at the origin point of the 3D cursor. And if you hold down the Shift key and right click, you can place this 3D cursor wherever you wanna go. So mine wasn't set at the origin, so that's where this sphere is created. Well, it's no problem. I have this transform window, and if you don't see this, you can toggle this by just hitting the N key on the keyboard. And what I'm gonna do is just set this here to 0, 0, 0. So we just have everything at the origin. And you'll notice as I go through this video, Blender has a lot of keyboard shortcuts, and I'm finding that to be quite challenging myself, because it's kind of difficult to try to find, you know, certain UI controls or tools here in the interface. But on the other hand, the keyboard shortcuts, once you know them, it really speeds up the workflow. So anyways, let's just kind of dive into here and take a look at some selection. So I'm just going to left click here, and it's going to select the sphere object, and I want to jump into edit mode. So that's just going to be hitting tab on the keyboard, and that's going to put me in this edit mode. Now the sphere is selected, so if I want to deselect, I'm just going to left click out here in an empty area of the viewport that just deselects everything. So now here at the top of my toolbar, I have the select box. I'm actually going to make sure that this is at the select and activate items option. And so I can just left click here, and you can see I'm selecting a face. Now I'm selecting a face because the mode that I'm working in here at the top, we have a couple buttons, and you can see that this option here is enabled, which is face select. So you have, you know, points or vertices, edges, and faces. And I can toggle between these by just hitting the 1, 2, and 3 key on the keyboard. So now that I'm in faces, left click on a face and it selects it. Again, to deselect, I can just left click out here in an empty spot, or I can hold down the control key and left click, and that's going to deselect. So let's say that I want to select everything that's connected to this face. So I can use control L on the keyboard to select connected. If I want to deselect, I can hit Alt A, that's going to deselect everything, or again, control L selects everything, just left click away from the mesh to deselect. So that's how I can do a select connection. Now here, like I said, at the top of the toolbar, we have some select options. If I hold down the button, you can see it expands, and I have 4 options here altogether, like a point select mode, a box select, a circle, and a lasso. And I can toggle between these by just tapping the W key on the keyboard. So here under just, you know, point select or just face select, I can just left click, and you can see that I'm just selecting these faces here. And if I hold down the Shift key, left click, I can select multiple faces. Hold down the control key and left click to deselect those faces. Now I'm gonna tap the W key, and that's gonna toggle the mode here to box select, and I can left click and drag to make a box selection here. Alt A, or left click away from the object to deselect everything. Once again, I'll hit the W key, and that's gonna take me here to basically kind of like a brush select mode. So if I just left click and drag, I can, you know, brush or paint select all the faces here. Again, if I hold down the control key and left click and drag, I can paint deselect the faces. Here, I'll just left click away to deselect everything. Once more, W, now I'm in lasso select, so left click and drag out, and I do a lasso select. Once more, W key, and now I'm back to just my point select mode. Now, when I'm in point select mode, if I hold down the control key and the right mouse button, I automatically go right in here to this lasso select. So there's another way to get to that lasso select. I'm finding just tapping this W key is pretty good to get me through the different kind of selection tools that I'm gonna be using throughout the process of modeling assets. All right, so next up, let's say that we wanna do a loop selection here. So if I hold down the Alt key and I left click on a face, I can do a loop selection. So here I'm gonna hold down the Alt key, the Shift key, so I can add to the selection, and then I'm going to left click on another face. And so now you can see I'm just making loop selections. Now, where you click on the face matters. So here I'm just zooming into the mesh. I'm gonna hold down the Alt key. And if I click on the center of the face, it's gonna give me this horizontal loop selection. However, if I were to, here, let me deselect. If I were to hold down the Alt key, left click towards the top of the face, it's gonna give me a vertical loop selection like this. So you can control the direction of this loop selection depending on where you click on the face. So now we're gonna talk about selecting a path. So let's say that I select this face, I hold down the Shift key, and I select this face. And what I really want is to have everything selected in between. Well, I can do that by just holding down the Control key. So left click, so Control key, left click, Control key, left click, and you can see that that is basically selecting everything within that path. This is the shortest path selection mode. So now I'm still holding down the Control key and I'm left clicking here, and you can see that it's just, you know, selecting the shortest path. Just another kind of quick way for me to do selections like this. So being able to select more or less is very handy in the modeling process. So let's say that I come in here and I make this face selection. I'm actually gonna hold down the Shift key and I'm just gonna select actually these four faces here. Now if I hold down the Control key and I hit the plus button on the number pad, that's gonna select or grow my selection. And if I hold down the Control key and then hit the or tap the minus button on the number pad, that's going to shrink this selection. So we can grow and shrink our selections this way. So another handy technique is being able to select every other component. So let's say that we select this face, I'm gonna hold down the Shift key and select this face. Now, I want to automatically just select every other face around this loop here in the sphere. And so now what I can do is hold down the Shift and Control keys and then go back to the number pad and hit the plus button. And you can see that's going to select every other face around this loop here of the sphere. Again, holding down Shift and Control, I can hit the minus key, and that's going to deselect every other face. So one last thing that I want to showcase here about selection, I'm going to use a lasso select. So here I'm just going to hold down the Control key and right mouse button and do a lasso selection. Now, if I pivot around the sphere using my middle mouse button, you can see that, well, I didn't actually have a select through working here. So I'm gonna go back, I'm gonna deselect. So this is something that I don't know if there's a better way to do it, but the only way I've been able to find out is if I jump into this mode here, which is called X-ray. And we can toggle this on and off by just using this button here in the UI, or I can actually hit Shift-Z on the keyboard. Then I'm gonna hold down my Control key, right mouse button to do my lasso select. And now when I pivot around the object, you can see that, well, it does work as a select through. So I think you just need to have X-ray mode enabled in order to select through the mesh. So that's gonna close out this video on selection here in Blender 2.8. Like I said earlier, I'm in the process of learning this myself, so I just wanted to make this video to see if this might be helpful for anyone else who's on this journey as well, coming from other 3D applications. Thanks a lot for watching, and I'll see you next time.